Shalom. Shabbat shalom. Send it salam. We're still in the 45th Shabbat or Senbet week, sabbatical, which is known as Ve'et Chanan, Chanan, grace, beseeching, where Moses, let's go to the Torah portion right here. I hear one of Wiki again. Right now, the King of Kings has placed an eye in our heart in the Holy Spirit, and even amongst many of the brothers, many of you all who we've reasoned on this, and others who have already made certain preliminary steps, you know, the new birth and to prepare one's spirit, soul, and their body. Now, in that order, don't forget the hierarchy, like the word says, that all things be done decently and in order. The Father is King, is King of Kings, and the Son is Lord of Lords. Make sure we recognize that order, because in this order and in His order is the peace and the provision for I and I, especially in these days and time. Give thanks, I and I, sister Emmanuel, who had linked I and I with a heads up about the whole Obamacare and the microchipping, and you know, we've touched on that, and there's a lot of information out there that one should become aware of. But in this Torah portion, reading and feeding, we notice something interesting where it says that this parasha, right, it tells of how Moses, he asks to see the land of Israel. So what's happening and what's about to happen at this particular point is that Moses, if you check out an old previous vid that we had put up, that Moses, Mashu, he's about to, at I think the age of 120, Mashu was about 120, Musa. Well, we find that Moses is about to pass on. Moses is about to go to the spirit world, the spirit realm, or about to die, as the heathen and sheathen say, we say, go to sleep or return to the fathers, all right? Or the spirit world, if you are able to receive that. Now, he put forth arguments to them to obey the law. Which law is Torah? For I and I as Rastafari and as Hebrews, or as Hebrew Rastafari, as the Beit Israel, as the once lost but now found, that we find ourselves in very difficult time, but Jah has not left us without the comforter and the Parakletos, or the Memphis Kedus, the spirit of truth. This is why we have been speaking and teaching and just proclaiming this, that ones need to know this for themselves. All right? They need to know the truth for themselves. Now, in this study, it talks about setting up cities of refuge, and we touched on that a little bit in part one. This vid right here is more focused on speaking to how we are without sanctuaries, and the monastery and even the nunnery or the sisterhood idea that has been placed not just in I and I heart and mind, but in many of the brothers and sisters heart and mind, right? As we touch on this Torah portion reading and feeding. So here Moses, and this is based on, you know, certain Eurocentric artists, so forth and so on, but still, and we can learn from this, and the Holy Spirit teaches us. It speaks on these particular points, this Torah portion, that Moses, the old or the previous, the one who led them out of Egypt into the wilderness, and who they went round and round after 40 years, now they are about to enter into a new generation. Let's remember that. And many of us are part of that new generation, and we're receiving links from brothers and sisters who are being born again and who are growing up, but they're going through a lot of persecution for the faith. You know what I'm saying? They're going through a lot of persecution among men and people. And so we lack sanctuaries. That's the main point of this, that we lack sanctuaries. Some of you brothers and sisters, the Wendemoch and the Hittoch, no doubt recall that we've been speaking about this. and some of our communication. And if you check the vids, we've also been speaking about this as well in the vids. Now, what we're talking about essentially is tabernacle. Remember that Yeshua HaMashiach says that salvation is of the Jews, but what does he mean by that? In other words, what is meant by that? Let's see if we can get a clearer of this right here. We might have to switch to the other form of it. Let's see without light. All right. How's that, brothers and sisters? That yellow right there. Well, we'll just leave that right there to just get a little clearer. But all of this you can look up. We're looking up tabernacle here. Now, we know that the tabernacle, this was the shadow. A shadow of things to come. We know that there's a spiritual, there's a metaphysical to this. But there's also a practical to the tabernacle and to the sanctuary. No doubt you also have heard of the Ark's temple and the Ark's tabernacle that is to be built, directed by I, Rastafari brother Rasa Siddiqui, and we've asked one to contribute towards that. Now we're here in the wilderness, and as the word of Jah is true, if the revelation of this is in this time that we're in, then no doubt you hear about the mark of the beast, and if you study the scriptures, there's a particular time of persecution. And these are some of the pages here on Wiki. And not on Wiki, but on the actual, this is the YouTubes right here. We looked up Obamacare microchip and what's hidden in one of the particular provisions of the Obamacare, Affordable Care Act, or whatever particular name you want to call it, about everyone being forced to be under a mandatory microchip. Some say, no, that's false. Others basically say there's a lot to that. And when we recognize what world we're in, you know, some folks just can't recognize that, you know, as are those who will do good even when others persecute them. There are those who will do evil even when others do good and seek good. You know what I'm saying? So we have to recognize the spiritual reality. That's why we always say that it is essential. It's the basic foundation of our faith. And the teaching of His Majesty of Kedamawi Haile Selassie, of Haile Selassie I, our Godfather and King of Kings, to be in the faith, to be born again in the faith of our Black Lord and Savior Yeshua HaMashiach, without exception. All right, that's the first step. One's spirit and soul, the psychological state is your soul. This is why some say, well, this is talk. Why don't we just go ahead and do? Because we need the instructions. We need to learn from the example, best practices and procedures. This is what we're learning, and hopefully we pray that one is learning this in the Torah portion, reading and feedings. So we need to establish holy places and sanctuaries on the churchical level, on the Bible study level, on different levels of operation depends on those who are in those particular areas. You must know what's in your area. Ones have asked about locals and for the Federation, and we let them know that it seems like ones, because of the unconstitutionality, have suspended the Constitution. You know, and just like the Ethiopians, the careless ones did in Ethiopia. So how do we survive? In fact, one brother in, I think Jenin, had commented, and hopefully you check this out, and we would like to reason with the eye in due time, but listen to this and receive this message here. One must be grounded spiritually. You know what I'm saying? The spiritual is essential. Don't go for these lies or dissemblers or other overly zealous ones who are basically Adis Christian or Adis Rastafariawian. In that sense, they are novices and really have a zeal but not that knowledge. We need sanctuaries. We need those holy places, even monasteries. You know what I'm saying? When we say monastery, we're talking about a brownstone. You know what I'm saying? Or we even have the kibbutz within, well, that work is still a work in progress. And there's other sites and location where brothers and sisters are basically gathering together, you understand, to live this way as a preparatory to coming out of this, and as well as for an emergency situation of surviving these, some say it's 5 months, that certain of these prophecies go through. We know that they are not forever. You understand, but with all this mandatory IDing and chipping and this and that, we've been asked about even the immunization. We have written letters for immunization and vaccination exemption over the years, and for the prison ministry and the prison projects. But really, we want to share the good news of His Majesty and for you to receive this so that y'all as well can do that which y'all can do in your particular areas, in other words, to represent. This is of our inheritance, brothers and sisters. And we have to grow up to Him in all things. Now, here we're on Goshen. Let's see if we can get a tighter frame of this right here. Goshen, right? This is Goshen right here, right? Goshen was a place that we know that the land of Goshen that's named in the Bible was a place in Egypt that was given to the Hebrews by the Pharaoh of Joseph. And it's a land from which they later left Egypt at the time of the Exodus. It was located in the Eastern Delta, and the name helps place the date in which the story was redacted during the period of the 7th to the 4th centuries BCE, the period in which the name was in use. The actual Exodus event would have preceded the writing and redaction of the biblical story by anywhere from 700 to 100 years, so forth and so on. And you can look more up on Jewish history. But what we look at the shadow here in the Old Covenant, Belui Kidon. But even in this time, they had Goshen, which is similar to what we have here when we look at Ve'et Hanan, or this Torah portion, the 45th Torah portion. You understand these sort of refuge cities. You understand? Because we have to gather ourselves together. You understand? The word says, gather yourselves together, O people that are despised. And this Torah portion here has a few interesting readings, and how these readings right here, you understand, are divided into seven aliyot. You understand? And it was those who will go up and those who will read from the Torah scroll, but it's what these particular readings are concerning. You understand? And then even furthermore in this particular Torah portion study, if you go through it, and here we're using the free Wikipedia page. You scroll through all of this and don't mind like the whitewash, so forth and so on. The overs, because we already should over that. That's a basic foundation of who we are and what has gone on and how do we end up or reach this particular prophetic point in time, and also where we go. Some say, are we waiting for Haile Selassie to return? You understand? After, you know, like the return, after the 120 years? They obviously don't know what they don't know, because they're novices. They don't speak the language of God, and therefore cannot receive the pure communication, the instructions, you understand, in and through the Moshiach, our black Lord and Savior, because they say that Yeshua is not God, but He is the Son of God and of the same essence and substance as God. But that's a whole other reasoning there. We're speaking now to the brethren and the sisterin who receive this. We need refuge cities. You understand? When we say refuge cities, they do not have to be all on the outer sense of refuge. We're speaking the spiritual word. You understand? And therefore, we're looking at the Old Testament through the light or the illumination of the Hadith, of the Birth Chadasha, of the New Covenant. You understand? This is what is lacking. Now, the key to it is the knowledge of the Son of God. We read that. We taught on that in the Rastafari Tewahedo, Part 1, 2, and 3. You can check that out. It's kind of a long teaching, but yet it goes in to those particular details right here. Now, this right here, what is this on? We missed this right here. Okay, Deuteronomy chapter 6, because this is now preparing them. You know what I'm saying? We have Shashamani. We know Africa is there. It is ours. But why are we not going forward? Because of this diverse, you know what I'm saying, and contradictory teaching out there that's confusing the people or robbing them of their blessing, their true barakat, you understand, in their new birth, and robbing them of their inheritance. You understand? Because it's not the teaching of His Majesty that prepares our spirit, our soul, and our body. You understand? In that order, it's not body and soul. Body doesn't come first. That's the worldly way. That's the way that you go astray. It's the spirit. It's that new birth. You see, in Deuteronomy, this is part of Deuteronomy 6 and 5. You know, this is very, very interesting concerning the heart. You understand, when we really start to understand. But basically, it is that heart. It's a real heartical. You understand? And how can we be heartical if we do not have the word of life? You understand? His message of my part, I glory in the Bible. Yovzen, and he exalts in Yeshua HaMashiach. So this is some of the Tefillim, you know, and so forth and so on, in the liturgy, in the Kedase, the weekly Makam, the Haftarah. And don't try to gorge yourself, my brothers and sisters. You know, study only so much as that, like food, like meal. You understand? Now, the Haftarah, it laments, you know, it's a lamentation, and it's read on the Tisha B'Av. Tisha B'Av, we know, is connected with 70 A.D., and that was the last real stand of the black Jews, or the Jesus Jews, the Yeshua Israelites, or the black Hebrew Israelites, or the Ethiopian Prolem, according to Tacitus. Mm-hmm. Now, this Haftarah, which is like the Missa in the Mikurab or the synagogue, even Rastafari synagogues. You understand? Overstand, my brothers and sisters. Rastafari yeshivas. We wanted to touch on that as well. We went right here to this page on yeshiva. And this is all in preparation. You understand? For Rastafari sanctuaries, holy places, places where we can come together, where we can congregate. And if necessary, certain places where we can survive these months of the Great Tribulation. You understand? Because that's our right. You understand? That's our privilege in Yeshua HaMashiach. And we can be those of Psalm 149. You understand? Psalm 149. Recognize that. But we'll teach on that. Now, the yeshiva is a place of sitting, is a place of Torah study, right? And how ones come together in these daily shiurim, which are the lectures, the classes, like y'all have come together on the internet and on the Ethiopian World Net channel, on the YouTubes, and on some of the other sister sites here and there on the web, you understand, and other gatherings, some that we know of, some that we don't know of, but if John knows, then John knows, then it is good. Now, yeshiva comes from the Hebrew word to sit, yeshiva, yeshiva. You understand? And it's what is in the Judaic way, the educational centers, the educational institutions. Now, of course, ones will say, well, you make a lot of focus on the Jewish part. Well, of course, it's the lion of the tribe of Yehuda. It's the lion of the tribe of Judah. That is our inheritance. So we have to recognize what the foundation is. Even Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ himself, says to the woman of Samaria. And remember, Samaria was, they were Hebrew or Jewish or converts and other related peoples, a mixed motley group of peoples like many Jews even today. However, Yeshua also extended that grace to them. Because we have a lot of our brothers and sisters in the state of Israel, Yosen, who are Rastafari, Yosen, who bear witness to the teaching of His Majesty, to His gospel, to His good news. So don't judge by the appearance of a thing, but judge by the righteousness. That means you need to be born again. You need to receive the Memphis Kedus, the Holy Spirit. That's the only thing. It's not even a thing, but that's what will get us through. You understand? Get us through these times of tribulation. Mm-hmm. So we've called for others to partner with us on the prison outreach ministries. We're also calling ones to partner with us on establishing sanctuaries, churchical establishments. It could be great or small, but the main thing is the people that come together to establish it. That's why we focus the teaching on the individual brothers and sisters and remind them, just like we want to be reminded and remind ourselves that we have a personal responsibility. You understand? And time is of the essence to redeem the time, because the days are kufu, are evil. Now, so we need to establish these educational institutions. Don't have to be a big old building. Mm-hmm. Lion of Judah and other churches and groups of faithful Rastafari brothers and sisters who have established those basic foundations of proper royal institutions and churchical institutions are there to also extend credit. That means establishing subsidiaries for others who might not know about the law and all of that. But in the faith, we trust and we verify. You understand? We trust and we verify. We need these sanctuaries. There's brothers and sisters who are homeless right now. One time there was Bingies. We could go to the Naya Bingi. I went to even the Bingi. And, you know, you can rest there. You understand? You can strengthen up there. you understand, you can get your spiritual wits, especially when you're going through great tribulation. We don't have those things. You know, the whole community is lamenting. So we're almost like sheep without a shepherd. Well, our shepherd is Yeshua HaMashiach. You understand? And let's recognize the tabernacle. This is the proper tabernacle. But we may not be able to set up, as they say, the tabernacle in this full sense. You understand? And that is not for us to do here in the so-called wilderness. But we need those sanctuaries. We have a few, you understand, which have a few, you understand, who are working together. And the main thing is the people. As Matthew says, the people are the most vital natural resource. It's the people, and it's the people, not just the bodies, but the people of faith. You understand? Those who have accepted, received the word, who have been born again, who are growing up, who have become as little children, as lijoch, as his dear, precious little children in Yeshua HaMashiach. That's the word. That's the Wengil. That's the gospel. That's what will get us through this life and the life to come. Because the church age is going through something right now, if you really notice what's going on with the church age. You understand what's happening to the churches and how the whole conspiracy, in other words, comes down to the churches. So we need to understand the Israelite camp. We need to understand the Israelite tabernacle, the principles that govern it, the spirit and truth. Because, see, that's in his way. You understand? He protects that which is in his way. He's not obligated to our tears, to our frustration, our suffering, but it's to his son. You understand? His son. He has sent his son, raised his name, Yeshua, Jesus, Christos, our black Lord and Savior. When will you people not get over just the blackness of it? Right? You know what I mean? The fact that he is racially Ethiopian or a black man, woolly here. All right. We got that. You understand? But let's go from the low degrees, as it were, to the high degrees in the teaching of his majesty. And now, what now puts that to the test is establishing in this time that we have right now. You understand? Starting small. Don't despise the small beginnings. Some say, Ross, we only have enough ones and ones for a Bible study, and just a few of us. What can we do? Well, establish a subsidiary. Establish a Bible study. Establish, better yet, a yeshiva. A Rastafari yeshiva. Because what is a yeshiva? You understand? You cannot deny that we are Hebrews, you understand, in the worldly sense of Jews. It's not saying the end of the Jewish age. It's not the end of the Judaic age. Even Yeshua HaMashiach told us himself. He told us himself that salvation is of the Jews. You understand? Salvation is of the Jews. You understand? Of the line of the tribe of Yehuda. You understand? Make I and I recognize, you understand, recognize that fact so that one can recognize that, you know, there's a lot of pages that speak concerning, you know, the race, you know, the race of Yeshua. And that's an important point, you understand, and that he carries us, you understand, he carries us, he still carries us if we have faith in him to the glory of our Father, you understand, of our Father, of the King of Kings. So, in recognizing this, you understand, in recognizing this, we now have to move spiritually. See, if we move spiritually in the unity of the Son of God, then establishing ourselves and working together is not a problem. Now, this right here, we put this here for the Havruta. The Havruta. What is the Havruta? You understand, the Havruta. The Havruta. Let's go to the wiki page right here. So these are some basics right here on the Rastafari sanctuaries. Now, for the unmarried or unwed brothers, you understand, it's the more monastical idea. You understand, and when we go to our divine heritage, our Ethiopic resource and the manuscripts, we find within that all the instruction and the instructional that we need. You understand, if we make our wills obedient to his good influence, then what is it? You understand, then what is it that prevents us from doing? It's like those lepers that stood at, you know, that sat down and said, why do we just stay here until we die? You understand? Why don't we get up and why don't we make a move? You understand? That's what we need to do right now, make a move. Instead of saying, well, we don't have this organization, that organization. The cornerstone is the church. You understand? And the church is based on the mikorab or the synagogue. You understand? What's called the synagogue. You understand? The tabernacle. You know what I'm saying? So we recognize Yeshua HaMoshiach. We recognize the easy things to recognize, the racial things to recognize. What prevents us? You understand? What prevents us is the lack of being born again and submitting ourselves to His will. To make our wills obedient, and therefore that is being disobedient as Rastafari to the teaching of His Majesty. You can say He's God all you want to say. You can say Lord, Lord, but if you do not the things that He say, what good are you? You know what I'm saying? What good are you to yourself? What good are you to your brother man and your sister woman? So we're going through some pictures right here, you know, going over some of the black pictures of Yeshua, and then there's some mockery pictures here and different ones who have spoken out on it, so forth and so on. Just to give a couple of placeholders right here, because it's important that ones kind of recognize some of the basic things. You understand? Like it says, somebody said right here, is it Obama? You see this right here? I don't know if you can see this. The light is on it. Let's just take the light off it for a moment so you can see it. I don't know if you can see. Is it Obama? No, it's little black Jesus of Nazareth, right? And this is the Ethiopian Yeshua, you understand? Or the Ethiopic, as we say, the Ethiopic Yeshua, the Ethiopic Jesus, if you will, Yeshua. Right, so we have the images. Okay, so now we want to get the real thing. Right, we have the image, so that should be clear. You know what I'm saying? It should be clear. You know the bronze feet, the significance of the bronze feet. You know the significance of it, brothers and sisters, is that where was Christ crucified? He was crucified in a place that was called Golgotha. Golgotha means the place of the skull. Right? Doesn't mean the place of the skull. Why do you think the brazen altar is brazen? You understand? It's brazen. You understand that right here. Now notice, I don't know if you can see all of this right here, but let's save this right here and let us grab a copy of this right here, the brazen feet image. You know, as we just go through some visuals, you understand? But it's not good enough. You know, woe to you if you recognize he's black. You understand? Just like one of us. And you don't walk in that way. You understand? But down here has some sneakers, you know, at the bottom of this, some pony or whatnot like that, you know, which is kind of interesting, you know, that ones take the eyes off of his feet, which conquer what? The skull and bones, you know what I'm saying? And the skull and bones, and black people now are like the valley of the dry bones. But it's for those of us who see, you understand? It's for those of us who accept the spirit and truth and who accept that reality. Because faith without what? Without works is what? Is dead. So we say we have this faith that he walked on waters, and even we see how Peter was able to walk on water. What threw him off? What threw Peter off? It was those winds that blew. It was what men and people say, oh, no, that's no spirit. Everything is flesh or material. You know, like just different nonsense. You know what I'm saying? But if they choose to believe such, you know what I'm saying? Every man got the right to decide his own destiny. And now with this whole mark of the beast thing coming out and all the other things, you know, rumors, you know what I'm saying? But still, whether they're rumors or not, we should be always prepared. You know what I'm saying? We should be always prepared. So we need I and I Rastafari, you know, we need I and I sanctuaries. You know what I'm saying? So those who are willing, then ones can reach out to even the prisoners, and reach out to others and those in their particular area. You know what I'm saying? And then we're really setting up the kingdom of heaven. When we're born again, we're actually born into the kingdom of heaven. You know what I'm saying? Into the kingdom of heaven. Recognize that. You know what I'm saying? We're born into the kingdom of heaven. It says that God would establish his own kingdom. That's what we have in the King of Kings, in spirit and in truth. It's not about the physical things. It's not about the outer things. There's some very beautiful pictures out here, some artwork. You know, I mean, and the artwork now basically says you have no excuse, because you can't say, well, we haven't seen it, well, we heard about it, and we read here and there, and we read what the historian said, Tacitus and the rest of them, about the Jews being of the race of the Ethiopians, but we don't see that. Every time we look around, we see white gases or Jesus or Caesar Borgias. We don't see it. Now there's no, absolutely no excuse. You understand? So what is it for I and I to do? Are we like some mockers or some curious folks? I don't know if they're mocking or not, but they basically say, are we waiting for Jesus to return? You know, like, are we waiting for His Majesty to return? You know, no. Jah is waiting for I and I to turn to Him in spirit and in truth. And just don't say, well, yes, I recognize you're black, and that makes us feel proud when we talk to Whitey, or, you know, when we talk to somebody else. But if we don't, remember, this is a spiritual warfare. It's not high and low places. You know what I'm saying? It's not high and low places. It's a spiritual wickedness in high places. The brethren asked about that. You know, the brethren had actually asked about that concerning putting on that full armor. Now, once we have our spiritual, our spirit right, and our soul, our psychological self right, then we're not under all these fears and phobias. Then it's like in the, almost like the Matrix. Things slow down. We can see the code. You know what I'm saying? We're not acting off of emotionality. You know what I'm saying? We're not acting out of that the kind of like the reptilian gut feeling. You know what I'm saying? The lower levels, the radio waves. We're acting from the gamma, you know, the gamma waves, the higher, the cosmic waves. You see, many people say, oh, that's just, you're just talking about that, until the scientists prove it in some way or another. So it's the sanctuaries that are important for I and I. You know what I'm saying? They can be, of course, inner city places. They'll be necessary, but we say that we should establish them along the Judea, going to our very root. You know what I'm saying? Going to our very root. This is why we brought up right here the yeshiva. And just skip through this for a moment. We'll call this Rastafari sanctuaries and yeshivas. You know what I'm saying? These are the study places. Let's read what it says. So yeshiva or yeshivot, right? Yeshivot, right? The yeshivot, right, is a Jewish or Judaic educational institution, right? Does His Majesty teach us that education is the key? That focuses on what? On the study of what? Traditional religious texts. Focuses on the study of traditional this kind of religious text, right? Like the Metz Kedus for I and I as Rastafari, Judahites, right? Primarily the Talmud, which is Talmudah, the studies, you know, getting familiar with it. That's what the root of it means. We have our own scrolls and manuscripts to study, thank you. But we'll study yours too. We'll compare it, right? And the Torah study, the Torah, the Orit. So those who have begun in this discipleship, you know, the Torah portions, you might not understand everything at one time. You understand? And His Majesty teaches that life is like a theater. One must not try to understand it all at once, otherwise it's no longer amusing. Amusing? Why is it amusing? Because we want this to have joy, the joy of Jah, of Yahweh, of He who is who He is, He will be who He be, His Imperial Majesty. Abba Kedus is I and I strength in and through Gitachinam and Hanatachin Jesus Christos, in and through our black Lord Adonai and Savior Yeshua HaMoshiach. So the yeshivas, you know, how we name these institutions are very important. So those who want to seek certain consultation, you know, can join I and I Haile Selassie Consultant Circle on that. And just, you know, post forward to it, and we're seeking to get these systems online, and we're also looking for your fellowship, which means partnering with I&I, and also having, you know, establishments that can meet the need where you are and where you are scattered in. You understand? Because there's no need for one to come way up here, and we don't have those resources. While we might have a next one in the next part that can receive them. But remember, we're receiving ones on the foundation of Yeshua HaMoshiach, on the teaching of His Majesty. Anything else is not like the monastery, the Rastafari monastery, sanctuary, the place to hang out and smoke weed. You know, nah. Will herb be used as a holy sacrament? There'd be holy sacrament because it's a holy place. However, it's not that kind of place. Make us understand that at the outset. That's what you think it is. Then maybe you need to do something else in your own name, not in our Father's name. Now, study is usually done through daily shiurim or shiurim, right? Lectures or classes, as we have with the Ethiopian World Net, with the Ilnet, and in study peers called Havrutas. Havrutas. Now, Havruta is a friendship, companionship. Now, here's what Yeshua said to us. When Yeshua, Jesus Christ, said, and He said to the woman at the well, He said that He said that y'all worship what you don't know, what you worship. You know what I'm saying? We know what we worship for salvation of the Jews or of Yehuda, of Judah, right? Of Yahuda, the praises of Yah. Right? We're not talking about Iscariotes, you know, we're not talking about Iscariot. You know what I'm saying? He was just one bad Judahite, one bad Jew right there, Iscariot. You know what I'm saying? There's another Jew, too, in the book of Jude. He's a Yehuda. He's a Judas, but he's not that Judas. So, understand these attention to details right here. But Yeshua says to her that, you'll worship what you know not. We know what we worship for salvation. Medane, the Medhane Olem, is of Yehuda, is of Judah. So we have to understand that we have to put on I way of life. You understand? Yes, we are in the Moshiach. And yes, the Moshiach is named Christ. But we have to also understand we're coming to the end of the church age, too. That's why a lot of the churches can't stand up against this abomination. They can't really. A few, yes. Maybe the Jesuits, you understand, like the Catholics, because they have the Jesuits. And His Majesty's people, the faithful Ethiopians, because they have us as Rastafari. We are like the so-called Jesuits, if you please. You understand, for His Imperial Majesty. You understand? But don't get it twisted. You understand? We're just making a comparison right there. You understand? By metaphor, by analogy. All right? So in study period, so when Christ sent them out, He sent them out two by two. The buddy system. Even the Mormons, they be doing that too, right? They send them two by twos. That's a good discipline there. And it's a way one can overcome their ego. You know what I'm saying? Their ego and their shego. You know what I mean? I was brassed longer than you. You're younger than me, and so you bossed up. You know, that's all the flesh. That's all displaying that one hasn't been born again. And that is what is not decent. That's indecent. That's not in and according to His shara'at. So the Havruta style of learning is one of the unique features of what the yeshiva. But when you understand that yeshiva means sitting, right? And sitting, tekemet, mekemet, means to be enthroned too. You understand? So we know Jah is still on the throne. So we have to understand this even if we go to the Egyptic level. We don't want to go there too fast, too soon, because a lot of people get confused. They're not able to see the rightful upgrade, and the upgrade we have in the Tawahido, the upgrade of the ancient pre-Christianity Christianity of ancient Egypt. But if you go a different way, you're not going through the gate. You see, the gate into the tabernacle, the gate into the tabernacle is Judah. You understand? If you notice right here, look how Judah is. Judah is right here, the gate into the tabernacle. You cannot get into the tabernacle. That's why when you see the arma of Negus and Neges, the insignia, you see the tabernacle. You understand? You see the throne, but you're really looking into the tabernacle. Remember, the throne of grace, that's where the Ark of the Covenant is in its symbolism. You understand, which is the throne of David, which is the throne of Yahweh. So it's not we're waiting for Him. It's really Jah is waiting for us. Everything He needs to throw this system out of balance is there. But it's His people. It's His sheeple. You understand, where are we? If that system is thrown out, if He says Nibiru come, and Nibiru come. If He says Nibiru go, and Nibiru go. You understand, what's going to happen to I down here? What is I organization? What is I order like? How many ones would fall through the cracks, as it were? You understand? Because they would just be out there or be cut off among the heathen and sheathen. You understand? Alone, isolated. So stay tuned also for evasion and survival techniques that we give thanks to the Texas Rangers, you understand, for showing us some of the evasion and survival techniques, which is interesting. The basic technique is man know thyself. You know, and then you'd be like, wait, well, isn't that what we use when we're talking about in consciousness? But that's what even on the so-called military level. You know, remember, this is the church militant, but not in the outer way. This is why you really have to restrain the flesh and be born again. Because a lot of folks are going to think, okay, this means doing it like what they're seeing in the movies and on TV. And they're going to get themselves and their loved ones hurt. You know, because they're outside of that obedience. They're not obeying the Wengil. They're not obeying the good news. So the yeshiva is the basic foundation. Now from yeshiva, of course, we go to the kibbutz. The kibbutz, that's a settlement. You understand? Where it's more of a community, like a farming community or another type of community. In this country, in South America, Central America, and the Caribbean. You know what I'm saying? But ideally in Africa. You know what I'm saying? Ideally. But we have the opportunity here, and many of you all even have land that you're not properly utilizing. You could be growing food. You could be doing a lot of different things out there. But first, you have to set up your status. You have to understand your status. You know what I'm saying? Your name and your status. Because if you come under the 13th, 14th Amendment, you can't really declare these things. Otherwise, there's a conflict in jurisdiction. So we have to come to our proper jurisdiction as black Hebrews, black Israel, as Beta Israel. This is why we seek to prove these things and provide the documentation and the evidence, you know what I'm saying, so that one can prove these things. We have Jewish, if you please, or Judaic identity. And it's about time that we as Rastafari, the true and the elect, the Lion of Judah society, Moa Anbesa Zem Negeda Yehuda Machiver, in the Americas, the Caribbean, and throughout the world, throughout the whole world, that we start to recognize and receive that which His Majesty Abba Kadus has so graciously given us in our Black Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. This is real, brothers and sisters. This part here is like child's play, basically proving that Christ was black and is black and will be black. You know, that's a basic fact. You know what I'm saying? But then they want to keep you. Some folks want to keep you on this level. You understand? On the fleshy, carnal level. Because they either know or don't know are being used to keep you off of the spiritual level. You understand? So you will not be able to spiritually war. You understand? See, it begins in the spiritual war before it becomes a psychological war. You understand? And then one to become bipolar. You understand? Or double-minded. And then it becomes a physical war. You understand? And then one falls from that true man state, that true maturity, and become almost bestial. We see it happen. You say, what's wrong with them? Are they possessed? Are they on drugs? So forth and so on. Somewhere along the line, they might have turned their backs on that message of salvation. You understand? And then the evil one, what it says, when anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand or comprehend it, then cometh the what? The evil one, and snatches out of their heart that which was sown. So they can hear about Kedamawi Haile Selassie. They can hear about Rastafari being black Hebrew, Yeshua HaMashiach, our black Lord and Savior. But if they don't understand and comprehend, that's why Christ says, stay in the upper room, pray to receive the Holy Spirit. So you can discern between truth and error, not on your own ideas, because you have to deny yourself. When you follow Christ, He says, deny yourself, deny your ego. You understand? The way we come looking at it from our worldly, deceived, deluded ways. In other words, test those things by the good news, by the Wengel, your Wengel, right? So the Havruta style of learning is one of the unique features of the yeshiva. So we need Rastafari yeshivas. You understand? Places we can come to study. And we mean to study. Not to say we're going to study, but do what? No, to study. You understand? To study. You understand? Because the spirit of truth. You understand? We're not even lying to the Gentiles or to the heathen. You understand? We don't have to. Because the truth is, you know, the truth is I and I shield and I and I defense. Because the God of truth that we worship, you understand? We know what we worship. We know who it is. You understand? That we give worship to. So then it goes on basically to say that in the United States and Israel, the different levels of yeshiva education have different names. In the United States, there's elementary school students that are enrolled in yeshiva. That's the basic discipleship that will correspond to I&I basic discipleship. There's the post-bar mitzvah age students that learn in a mesivta, and we'll get into that. The undergraduate level students that learn in the base midrash, the beta midrash. Right, the Darasa, Medresh, to reach, they reach a certain level, or the Yeshiva Gadol, which is the bigger yeshiva, or the large yeshiva. Now, in Israel, or the state of Israel, elementary school students are enrolled in a Talmud Torah, or a Chiddah, that's like the word Bamarinya, Chiddah, that means to dwell. That's a dwelling place where we get the Amharic Madir. Yeah, Maderia. In my father's house, there are many Maderia. Post-bar mitzvah age students learn in the yeshiva katana. The yeshiva katana are a small kitten, you know, like a small, like we say, tinnish, right? A small yeshiva. And school age or high school age students learn in the yeshiva Gedola. So it's done a little different in the state of Israel, like on their more or less home, what they claim in, as home territory, and then what's done out in, like, say, America. Then it also has the kollel, right, which is a yeshiva for married men, which pays stipends to its students. In other words, they pay the married men to study Torah, the Orit, so that the time that they might be away from any other kind of work or employment can be a stipend to help their families, their women, and their children. So see how they love one another? Why don't we love one another? This is our foundation. This is what we turned our back on. Remember what John said, that he will raise up a people who are no people to provoke us? You understand? To provoke us to get our acts together. Are you not provoked enough? You understand? It's not fighting against these and those. It's getting our Father's house in order. So historically, yeshivas were attended by males only. Today, all non-Orthodox and many modern Orthodox yeshivas are open to girls and women. Now, for the daughters, there must be a level of sisterhood as well. You understand? Where sisters can really ground themselves. You understand? Develop their skills. You understand? And then if they choose to go into the world, into whatever, you know, whatever that the Almighty calls them to, you understand, all for different assignments in the kingdom of the King of Kings and His Christ. So be it. So study this page up a little bit more. We're just touching on this. We didn't think we'd get into this so much. This is giving us an example. We're going to the basics. You understand? We're getting to, like, the basics, you know, the basic building blocks. So these are all some of the basic building blocks. All right, you know, see what the brothers or these Jewish brothers here are doing, studying. We think they're just wasting time reading. Don't you see how that also gives them the jump or the edge? Because they really, it's like Esau. I remember Esau and Jacob, where Jacob put on Esau's his garment, so to speak, right, and had the blessing. Now we're in the latter days and times, and so things are flipped, the script reversed. So we're looking at the principles that help to teach us. You understand, and we can verify them by our own Ethiopic resources. So this portion here, this is once again the land of Goshen. Goshen is an example of a Goshen land. We have something like a land of Goshen now, but still it's under development, you know, or in developing, because it can only develop as far as the real members is not how much land that's there, or how much even resources or equipment, is how much ones of the true faith, you understand, and those who are working in the true faith. So these are the ones that we can unite with, you understand, and be of the same mind in that which is concerning the King of Kings. You may want Itel stew, and I may want Itel chunks or something else, or beans and rice or whatever like that. You understand? There's no commandment about that. It's not a high holy day. We can choose those things. But those things which concern our basic building blocks, see, that's what's going to protect us. What will protect us? The way, the truth, and the life. So if we say we have faith in the King of Kings and His Christ, then what more do we do than others out there? You understand? That say they have faith, but they do not. You understand? Their faith, therefore, is dead. So the living faith is what we are concerning right here. It's this living faith of the King of Kings and His Christ. So we need, brothers and sisters, to start to seriously reason on cities of refuge is a code word that we utilize in this Torah portion, Ve'et Hanan, Yovsen, or Lemenuhu, Yovsen, this particular Torah portion right here. But the real idea is the yeshivas, you understand, in the sense of the monasteries and kind of sisterhood nunneries, so to speak. You understand, for daughters, you understand, for unmarried daughters, you understand that. And then there can be other places as well for sisters who might have youths, or other places for other ones according to their kind. You understand what I'm saying, my brothers and sisters? This is very, very important that we start and start to pray on this. The first thing really is to start to pray on this. You also start to pray that His Holy Spirit will make us the right people. He said, next time, send the right people. Who are the right people? It's the righteous people. Who are these righteous people? It's I and I in the King of Kings and His Christ, our black Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. We cannot enter to the Father except through Christ. And that's where we agree with the testimony of His Majesty in fullness. That's the essence. That's the rock. That's the cornerstone. And so anyone who calls on the name and doesn't affirm this good news, is seeking to rob the brothers and sisters of their inheritance. You know, and their inheritance in being heirs of God and co-heirs of Yeshua HaMashiach. So that first place, the holy place, must be is within this temple. You understand our reasonable service, as Romans chapter 13 reminds us, that reasonable service. What is that reasonable service? You understand? It reminds us of that reasonable service. So we first have to begin with our individual responsibility. You understand? Each one, you understand, in their meditation and prayer time. You understand? In and through Yeshua HaMashiach. That's the gateway. That's the stargate right there. It's Yeshua. It's his name. You know what I'm saying? It's a faithful witness to his word. You know what I'm saying? Not denying when you know and you've been convinced and persuaded of his racial identity. You can't say whether he's purple or green or yellow or, you know, polka dot. That's silliness. And that's also blasphemy, too. You know what I'm saying? Don't go there. You know, like Miss Quino. You understand? Blessed is the man that doesn't go in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the way of the sinners. Don't stand in the way that they stand, nor sit in the seat of the scorners, those who want to scoff. You understand? The teaching of Torah, of study of the scripture, of the Metzav Kedus, of getting our house on the rightful foundation. And no other foundation can be laid but our black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It's not about waiting for him to return. You understand? It's about, because he's with us, according to Matthew chapter 28. He's with us even to the end of the age. And this is the end of the age. He didn't leave us. So why are we looking for him to return? No, it's not the return of Christ in that sense when you really understand. It is the revelation. And that revelation, remember, we are the body of Christ. So that revelation of the head is not without the body. And when the head and the body now is joined and fitly, then all these other things are brought under his sweet, sweet feet, under that brazen, that symbolic that we have right there of the brazen altar. You know what I'm saying? You know, the brass feet. You know what I'm saying? Which conquers skull and bones, because he was crucified in the place that was known as Golgotha. You know what I'm saying? That Golgotha. So he already conquered that. That's why he said all power is given to him. You know what I'm saying? But this world is not his world. You have to understand that. This world, he has created that world, the kingdom of heaven, where we enter into the new birth. You know what I'm saying? Through the metanoia, through being born again, through that reception. And we continue to grow through denying our ego, our own, you know, faulty way of looking at things that's getting us in so much trouble, and seeing the illumination of his word and his spirit and that joy and that shalom and that peace that we have. He has given us his shalom. You understand? How important and powerful is this? A lot of ones don't have this shalom, so they're going through all sort of psychotic mental breakdowns, and then they're prescribing all these pharmaceuticals, these sorceries and other things. You know what I'm saying? It's that power of prayer. You know what I'm saying? But it's that power of prayer is based on our faith, our admittance, our true and faithful, you know what I'm saying, admittance. When we understand what Amen, you know what I'm saying, in Revelation chapter 3, verse 14, how that is the pie, the phi right there. You understand? That's the true sacred geometric. You understand what he says there? He's the beginning. You understand? The true and faithful witness in the beginning of the creation. We are of a new creation who are born again, and we have become sons and daughters of Abba, Father, in and through our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. You understand? So it's not working in the worldly sense of working and toil, but it's a joy. When we truly are born again, we find these things a joy because our whole understanding is opened up. You know what I'm saying? We begin to recognize. We begin to see. You know what I'm saying? We recognize. And once you begin to see, you recognize how blind you were. And so pray. You know what I'm saying? Pray for that for that ability, even spiritual, to see and receive this message. We need our sanctuaries. And the first sanctuary is that sanctuary within our spirit, our soul, and our body. And to, when it says to be baptized in the name of Jesus, it says to baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. We have to recognize the name of the Father, and the name of the Son, and also recognize in what is the power or authority of the Son's name. The Yeshua's name has a power in certain ways that's been given specifically for the sons and daughters. See, and the gospel, the good news, says it, you know, over demons. You know, in his name they shall cast out devils in Yeshua's name. That's why they ask you, don't talk about Yeshua. Don't talk about Yehoshua. Don't talk about what his race is. Don't speak about that. Okay, yeah, we know he's black and everything, and then we have Buddha, and they bring everybody else in, you know, all these other people, as though they're of equal standing. They're not of equal standing. We don't regard them as being of equal standing. We regard them as looking towards Yeshua. You know what I'm saying? If they had any real overstanding, they were looking towards the Messiah, because from the very fall of Adam, the original primordial black man, you know what I'm saying, and humanity in general, seeing all that comes out of the black seed, out of that dominant gene, all the different shades, all the different types, you know what I'm saying, they were looking towards the Moshiach for 5,500 years. So we have to recognize why these numbers are there. Some don't understand that, unfortunately, but may they pray for wisdom. You know, they don't know why we have pointed to the 120th year of Lich Tesari, of the Son of Man. What's the relevance of that? Can't you see what's going on? They're saying, well, what do we do now? What, so what? What's to go on now? And so what are they telling? They're not telling you anything. You know, if anything, they are, it's a very carnal, material, outer thing. You know what I'm saying? It's not being guided by his spirit. You know what I'm saying? And therefore, the soul is not really saved. The psyche, you know what I'm saying? You know, there's a danger there. It's like warning. You know what I'm saying? Because it claims to be of Abba, Father. You know what I'm saying? Of Kedamawi, Haila, Shalasi. But it's not. And I don't know if these people are knowing, doing this or not, whatever. That's not really my to choose or to decide. The word, it judges. You know what I'm saying? And this is why it says to proclaim the word, to minister the word. My brothers and sisters, somewhat, you know, somewhat, I won't say long-winded, but it's good to be long-winded. They say that one's lung has to strong to smoke sentimania, right? Right. That's what was said then, right? So I hope that ones are getting this basic message. We looking at all this Obama stuff and the Obama legislation and what's supposed to happen with this whole microchip thing, and you know how soon it is. You know what I'm saying? Recognize that our Father has given all power to Yeshua HaMashiach, and we are in Him in spirit and in truth. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, well, woe to I and I if we are not. You understand? So there's no faking the funk. You see, some folks, they will tell you all that spiritual stuff. There ain't nothing to all that spiritual stuff, because I know people who know the Bible and rah, 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 rah. You know, they're talking this intellectual stuff from, you know, a worldly perspective. What they basically are telling you is that they have more faith in the world, you know what I'm saying, than they do in Yeshua. You know what I'm saying? In the Spirit of God in Christ, in the Word of God in Christ. And you have to remember that this is a spiritual warfare, because it's a warfare, you know what I'm saying, for your trust, for your confidence, you know, to make you believe a lie. If you don't have a love of the truth, there's really little more that we can really say for you. Just pray that God, that Jah, has mercy on your soul. So we need Ayanai Rastafari sanctuaries, the yeshivas, you understand, and those that want to co-partner and labor in this effort, you know, make Ayanai know, because we're leaving from Moses, and we're entering now into the Joshua age. You know what I'm saying? And the Joshua age is the coming out age. But there's some key preparation that we need to, you know, make and be in before this time. You know what I'm saying? Before the fullness of this time. But remember, the Father is being merciful. He's still extending, you know, amazing grace. You know what I'm saying? Not for the heathen and sheathen's sake, but for I and I, his dearly beloved children's sake. You know what I'm saying? So let's not fall from this grace. You know what I'm saying? Let's not fall from his grace and be led aside, you know what I'm saying, by all sort of slights of doctrine and wind of this and that. It's very easy to see that it's not in the submission You understand? You know, it's not in the submission of Yeshua HaMashiach. It's not in Father's order. It's not in that proper order. And if it's not in order, you understand? Then you know if something's not in order, then it's definitely out of order. You understand? And we've been out of order for far too long. We have an amazing grace right now. You understand? There's no need for ones to panic. You understand? But for ones to watch and pray, to work and pray. You understand? To ask the Father to send His Holy Spirit to guide them in the Word, and therefore to discern spirits, so that one can discern those who have that doctrine, the true teaching, the Timaharit of Yeshua HaMashiach. You understand? And for Ainias, faithful and like Rastafari of His Imperial Majesty, which confirms everything and more that we know in the gospel, the good news. Everything that we learned in the former way, you understand, under the Gentile Christianity that was true, we found out is true and even more so through the King of Kings and His Christ. And we share this freely with you all, brothers and sisters. So, you know, make copies of this, post this elsewhere. You understand, share this with your brothers and sisters. It's very important for us to watch and pray and to be diligent in these times, and also to prepare while we have the time to redeem these days and time, you know, these days, this end time, because the days are exceedingly evil. But fear not. That's the main thing. Stay in His peace. Fear not. You understand? Learn what that perfect peace is. With our mind stayed on Him, beholding Him in spirit and in truth. You understand? Recognizing He's black, but don't get caught up on that. Don't get caught up on the flesh. Not even His beautiful black flesh, which reflects I and I humanity and has lifted us up. That takes a whole psychological burden off of it. That means we should be able to walk now, you understand, in His spirit and in truth. And to even, like walk on that water. You understand? Walk through this trod, in other words, to yard. You understand? With boldness of faith and with confidence. You understand? But being rightly guided, that's the main thing. Don't be overzealous and outside of the knowledge of the Son of God. Don't try to establish your own righteousness. We don't have any righteousness but our black Lord and Savior, but Yeshua HaMashiach. He is our righteousness. He is the one who has borne I and I sorrows. You understand? You know, He's the one who takes all that guilt trip of the old man. You understand? If one would only submit themselves, you understand, to His good influence in the gospel, and those who preach and teach and who live the gospel in spirit and in truth. And, you know, we ask, of course, for the brothers and sisters to pray for I and I. You understand? As well. You understand? But do what you need to do where you need to do it. And if you are of the mind to establish, even if it's a Bible study, you understand, even a Bible study as a basic Rastafari yeshiva, you know, the Rastafari yeshiva of wherever you are at, you know, on our Judaic foundation, of course. Now, of course, in some areas, you know, it might seem like this, it might seem like that, but we're holding to our faithful foundation so we can begin to build, you understand, really build up one another, and we can come to that point of unity. You understand? We already explained to you why, you understand, why there is lacking, you understand, that particular unity, because we're not in the knowledge of the Son of God. Ones are going, you know, every way but Jah's way. You understand? Affirming everything, even saying that His Majesty is God, you understand, but denying, denying I and I, Black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You understand? And His Majesty, you know, him not do that. You understand? So let's just look up right here, reasonable. Let's go to reasonable, right? Reasonable service. Reasonable service. And we'll conclude on reasonable service, just to remind you of this word. Now, it's in the book of Romans, which is very interesting because we're in a kind of a Roman Gentile, you know, world order. If you really recognize it, if you're able to receive it, we're in a Gentile world order. So we're in Romans too, right? Now, Romans says what? Romans says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, when the moch. And say, I call you brethren because you seek to do the will and learn the will and do the will of our God and Father, of our Kadosh, of Kedush Habatach and Kedamawi Haile Shalase. And you receive his testimony, therefore you receive Yeshua HaMashiach into your heads and into your heart. You're sent to be your Adonai. You're sent to be your Gita. You're sent to be your Lord and Savior. You're sent, he is our high priest as well. You're sent to the glory of our Father. He is the Lord of Lords. Yeshua HaMashiach is the Lord of Lords. That's why you'll never find in any official document where His Majesty takes up the title of Lord of Lords. Many Rastafari say so, because that's a little bit eschatological, if you understand. That's in the spiritual abstraction, recognizing the Father and the Son and the Father, and that mystery of God in Christ. Even though maybe not being able to articulate it scripturally, it is true in that sense. But let's understand who is the Father as King of Kings and who is the Lord of Lords, Yeshua HaMashiach. He is the governor among the kings of this earth, and all authority has been given to him. So if we are in him and through him, to the Father be all, you understand, then we have that overcoming. You understand, we just need to grow up. What is needed for us to do? To grow up. You understand, to be grown-ups, not be children in knowledge, tossed and turned to and fro. Very little slight of thing, iffy, maybe. You understand, yay, yay, nay, nay, wishy-washy, no. I beseech you, I beg you. And it's interesting because this beseeching is just like the beseeching that we have in this Torah portion. You understand, and ve'et hanan, or lemenuhu. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, by the mercies of Ha'elohim, by the mercies of Igziyavihar Lotu Sibhat, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice. Remember Barhana Selassie, he sung on the Ionai as a living sacrifice? You understand? Not some sacrifice, because the living sacrifices of the living God. The dead sacrifice, that's, you know, we see a lot of that in this world system. You just go out and look at the Illuminati, how they sacrifice this for and sacrifice that. But we present ourselves. That means we are his property. We belong to him. You know what I mean? We declare that. So if they touch this, touch not mine anointed. So we have to declare with firmness of faith that we are his anointed and not doubt it at all. So woe, what a woe, what a nibiru woe to them. You know what I'm saying? If they touch the anointed, and will they touch some of I and I? They might. Father might allow that to be so that the number be fulfilled. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? By the way, we present ourselves a living sacrifice. Kiddush, holy, kiddush. So the holy place is for those who understand what kiddush means in spirit. And in truth. That means spiritually, they can understand it in the spiritual, but also in the truthful, the reveal. You understand? That means to have the faith and display that by their work. You understand? Which is the grace, right, of Jah. Acceptable to God, which is your what? Reasonable. You see, that's our reasonable service. What is our service? It tells us right here. What is our reasonable service, right? And be not, right, and be not conformed to this world. So you're seeing a lot of stuff, mark of the beast, this. But we can't be conformed. But be ye what? Transformed. Transformers, more than meets the eye, right? Transformers. But spiritually, we are transformed because we are Hebrews. We're crossing over. You're saying crossing over that River Jordan. Remember the Israelites, when they came to the River Jordan, they turned back. Remember what Joshua, Yeshua, had to do? You understand? Old Testament Yeshua is what we have to do as this New Testament Yeshua, what we have to do to bring I and I people into the promised land. They've already come out of Egypt when they cite the light of Rastafari. They're not in mystery Egypt or spiritual Egypt, which crucifies our Lord. They've come out of that, but they're in the wilderness of the Americas and the other wildernesses elsewhere. But we're specifically speaking to the Judahites first and foremostly. You know, speaking of us as Afro-American and those in this territory of the Americas and surrounding Americas, Yovas, and be not conformed to this world, to this seclurum, but be what transformed by what? By the renewing of your mind. This is key, the renewing of our mind. His Majesty speaks about the discipline of our mind, the discipline of mind. You understand? That's a basic ingredient, a basic. That means that's like 1, 2, 3. That ye may prove what is that good. So you're not, when you hear something or someone reason, if you're in that renewed mind and you come to that maturity, you can prove it. You understand? You can prove it by his word. You can prove it even experientially. You understand? Or perhaps disprove it. You understand? And acceptable, but here is that we may prove we're looking for what is that good. We're looking not for the evil, but we're looking for that good, because good over evil, and acceptable, and the perfect what? Will of God. Remember brotherhood? Brotherhood is all about those who seek to do the will of God, the same as I and I brother, I and I sister, I and I mother, because we only have one father. Let's understand that. So we have to do this word in its purity. You understand? And it's just easy. It's not a burden. His yoke is light. It's not heavy. For I say, through the grace given to I, or to me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think. So all of I and I have to think soberly. You understand? We have to think soberly. Think, when we say rationally, but soberly in the way of the King of Kings and his Christ. According, which is according, as God, Ha Elohim, hath dealt to every man the measure of faith. So some have faith to do this, like through a bookstore or like a bookshop or like a kind of a coffee shop. You know what I'm saying? Or one might do another sort of establishment. You know what I'm saying? We're not looking at no big old big. We're in the tabernacle mentality. A tabernacle is a tent. That means we can put it together, you know what I'm saying? And we can dismantle it and move on.